So Brandon Crawford, they're talking about Canelo against Triple G at Dodger Stadium.
Yes.
I haven't been there in many years. How many people fit in the stadium?
I'm not a big baseball guy. 800 grand?
How many people? 80,000? Dodger Stadium?
I don't know.
50,000. 50,000? Dodger Stadium?
50,000.
What? Are you counting the 50,000?
Yeah, I wish I was.
So Brandon, what do you think? Canelo Triple G, do you want to see it? Do you want to see it at the MGM? Do you want to see it in Dallas Cowboys Stadium? I think Dallas Cowboys Stadium is a good place. 120,000 fans, maybe 100,000.
That's, yeah.
And if they make they price the tickets right, like 10 bucks for the cheap, you sell out right away.
It could be great. Didn't Manny sell 55,000 there or something like
more,
that?
More, like 75, 80. Canelo himself sold 56 against Kirkland on half of the stadium on a 3-4 week notice.
Okay. So well, of course, for the LA boy, I would rather be at Dodger Stadium.
Of course, me too, because it's easy. Who do you like in that fight?
I like Canelo, man.
Are you in the majority? Or are you?
I think I'm in the minority from everybody I'm speaking with.
Everybody says Triple G?
Yeah, a lot of people are thinking Triple G. Yeah. But I'm thinking Canelo, you know? He's definitely, his resume is much better, you know? Whether you thought he beat Lara, he was in there competitive with him.
Where nobody else wants to fight Lara.
Nobody even
want
to fight
Southpaw.
And Canelo, the biggest superstar in boxing, definitely didn't need to fight him. But he did it to gain the experience and get better, you know?
Trout at his prime.
Trout had just coming off the win over Miguel Cotto. Looking solid. A lot of people were expecting him for the upset.
He beat Cotto clearly, although Cotto says that he beat Canelo. That was
he beat Cotto, but it is clearly Miguel Cotto, right? Know what I mean?
Yeah, just because he didn't knock him the fuck out doesn't mean he didn't lose. He beat him.
He is, by leaps and bounds, been in there with the superior
Okay, who did Triple G fight? The biggest names. I mean, he fight Curtis Stevens, Gabe Rosado, Willie Monroe.
Yeah, not A-plus guys.
Danny Jacobs.
And Danny Jacobs gave him hell. You know, the first night we had him in there with somebody, he gave him hell.
So you like Canelo's resume with Shane Mosley on there and...
You know, of course there's asterisks behind every name. Shane Mosley was miles past his prime. You know, we can go down the list.
James Kirkland.
James Kirkland had already L's. They knew he was shitty.
Liam Smith, I'm not very familiar with.
Liam Smith,
the belt.
He's a solid fighter, but he's not A-plus fighter. Look, Liam Smith, a very solid fighter, and Canelo dominated him.
What happened when Canelo sparred Triple G? You know they sparred a few years back, like 4 or 5 years ago.
Yeah, Triple G totally got the better of it, and I think Canelo was like 18 or 19 years old. And tons has changed since then, you know what I mean?
Is it an advantage for you to fight a guy you sparred, or disadvantage? Because you think like you know him, you think his power, you think...
Yes.
But sometimes you can put up a bad showing in sparring and know better.
Exactly. You know, you don't know what that particular day was, and again, that was many, many, many years ago. These guys have gotten better. Dion, let's get a body shield on Adam. And we're going to have Adam throw punches at Mike, and Mike's going to punch in between at those shots.
I'm excited about that one, Canelo Triple G.
How many
pay-per-views do you think it sells? Canelo Chavez Jr. just sold 1 million. Is it more than Canelo Chavez?
More.
More?
More. More. The same or more. Better or equal.
All right, there you have
Greater than or equal to.
There you have it, Brandon Krause. What do you guys think? Canelo against Triple G, does it sell more pay-per-views than Canelo Chavez? FuseReporting.com, Mike's Reporting.